सॉयर सिंड्रोम और सॉयर जेम्स सिंड्रोम. इन दिस सिंड्रोम वी हैव मेल्स यू नो हेमाफ्रोडिटिज्म, दैट इज इन दीज पेशेंट्स द जीनोटाइप इज नॉर्मली ऑफ मेल, दैट इज 46XY, बट द फिनोटाइप इज फीमेल, दैट इज वाई दे आर कॉल्ड मेल्स यू नो हेमाफ्रोडाइट्स. वी कैन ऑल्सो कॉल इट एज प्योर XY गोनेड्रल डिसजेनेसिस बिकॉज द गोनेड्स आर नॉट फॉर्म्ड इन दिस सिंड्रोम. The cause of this syndrome is gene mutations, but what causes this gene mutations is not known. The main genes that are associated with this syndrome are SRY gene, we have MAP3K1 gene, DHH, NR5A1. Now the most important mutation of these genes is SRY mutation. This gene is normally located on Y chromosome and it is responsible for producing a protein which is called sex determining region Y protein. This protein in a normally growing fetus will produce testes, and these testes will further produce testosterone and MIF, that is malarian inhibiting factor. So in presence of malarian inhibiting factor and testosterone, the female reproductive organs will not be formed and the fetus will develop into male. But now we have a mutation in this protein, in this gene, and so this protein is not formed, so there is no development of testes and there is no production of testosterone and MIF further, so the fetus grows into female line production. So generally this syndrome is not inheritable, but in case it is inherited, it depends on which gene mutation is present to find the type of inheritance pattern. Now here, if we have SRY gene mutation, we will have Y-linked inheritance pattern, of course, because this gene is located on Y chromosome. If we have DHH mutation, we will have autosomal recessive pattern. In case of MAP3K1 or NR5A1, the autosomal dominant inheritance pattern is seen. Now further, in these fetuses, we have presence of uterus, fallopian tubes and cervix, and the external genitalia is also of female, but there are no gonads. The gonads are present in the usual place in the form of streaks, or we also call this as streak gonads. There will be only a band of fibrous tissue, functionless fibrous tissue, that will be present in the place of gonads, and this gonads are represented by a term which is called streak gonads. So we do not have real testes, or we do not have real ovaries. Just in place of them, we have a fibrous tissue band. Now these people are raised with female gender identity. They are usually reared as females, and they come to medical attention with primary amenorrhea and also absence of secondary sexual characters. Now these symptoms develop because we do not have gonads, so we do not have any estrogen, or we do not have any testosterone also. So hormone replacement therapy during adolescence is necessary to induce menstruation in these girls and development of secondary sexual characters. Now secondary sexual characters here is referred to as breast development, pubic hair, axillary hair, etc. These are not very well defined in these girls. So there are no eggs, that is why these females are infertile, but in vitro fertilization can be tried because the uterus is present. For diagnosis, clinical diagnosis is enough in some cases, but karyotyping or genetic testing is also needed. We also need ultrasonography to exclude some tumors and also to diagnose the streak gonads. For the treatment, apart from giving hormonal therapy, we have to give cyclic progesterone and estrogen therapy. The surgery is also necessary to remove the streak gonads because they carry a very high risk of malignancy. So this surgery to remove the streak gonads is called gonadectomy, and it is usually performed at puberty.